strong. He'll do anything, big or small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there.
Core friends, welcome to the Kids Core Superhero Clubhouse. My name is Superhero Caitlin, and I am so excited that you are here. Superheroes are awesome because they can do big things to help other people. Not to mention, they are strong, brave, and they get to wear cool costumes, like this cape. Guess what? God made you to be strong and courageous so that you can do big things. Do you want to be a superhero too? That's great, because God made you so that you can do big things for others. In the Bible, in Deuteronomy 31:6, it says, "Be strong and courageous." Can you say that with me? Be strong and courageous. Deuteronomy 31:6. God is telling us to be strong, but He doesn't always mean be strong by showing off our muscles. Our minds can also be strong. We can have a strong mind by making hard choices and not giving up. When God tells us to be courageous, that means to be brave. I think it's brave to try new things, make new friends, and to talk to people about how you are feeling. I bet that if we practice being strong and courageous, we can all be super kids for God. If you want to be a super kid, show me your best super kid pose on three. One, two, three. Awesome job. Today we are going to hear a story from the Bible about a man named David. Let's turn on those super kid listening ears and see what big things God is teaching us.
Just follow me through.
Ho, ho.
Follow me through. Follow me through, ho. Oz got a Bible story for me and you.
Right. That should do it.
Oh, hola, friends. I'm Luis, the handyman. I just replaced the batteries in this for my niece. She uses it to play her music and practice for her dance class. She loves to dance. Ooh, that reminds me of today's story. Do you want to help me build it? Great. Let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres. Hammer. Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now we just need our story tools. Yep, that's perfect. Okay, so all month long, we've been hearing stories from the Bible about a guy named David. Whoa! Look at David dance. I think he's celebrating someone special. Do you know who he's celebrating? God! David's dancing as a way to praise and thank God. David knew that God made him to do big things. What big things did David do? Well, let's play a game and see if we can remember. I'm going to ask you some questions about David, and you shout out the answer. Are you ready? Question number one. When David was a shepherd watching his flock of sheep, an animal came and took one of the sheep. What kind of animal was it? Was it a giant octopus? Or was it a mighty eagle? Or was it a lion? What's the right answer? Shout it out! Yes! A lion! That's right! The lion grabbed the sheep, but God made David to do big things, and David saved the sheep! Okay, here we go. Question number two. David did something really big that other people were afraid to do. Was it take everyone some pizza? Was it build a snowman? Or did David challenge a giant named Goliath? Which one? Shout it out! If you said challenge the giant Goliath, you are right. God made David to do big things, and he knocked down the giant. Okay, last question. When David became king, he helped someone. Who did David help? Did David help a kangaroo? Did David help a woman cross the road? Or did David help Jonathan's son, Mephibosheth? What's your answer? Shout it out! That's right! God made David to do big things, and he took care of Mephibosheth. Great playing, everyone! God made David to do so many big things. And that's why David celebrated and praised God by dancing! And making music and singing songs. David praised God because he wanted to say thank you. Now, raise your hand if you think God made you to do big things too. Wow, so many hands. And you're right, God made us to do big things. Which means we can dance too. Oh, Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who made you to do big things?
God made me to do big things. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who made you to do big things?
God made me to do big things. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Adios. Ooh.
Wow, God made David to do so many big things. Let's thank God right now on the count of three. Let's say, yay, God! One, two, three. Yay, God! Hey, Super Kids, are you ready for the Kids Core Challenge this week? This week, the Kids Core Super Kids Challenge is to have a celebration for God. You could get some streamers and turn on some music and have a fun dance party. God would love that. I think that we should celebrate right now. Stand up and dance, dance. Woohoo! Awesome celebrating, friends. Before we go, let's pray and talk to God. Dear God, it is so fun to celebrate you. Thank you for making us, and thank you for celebrating with us. We love you so much, God. Amen. I want you to remember that God made you to do big things. Now let's go out there and be super kids for God.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord keep you.
May the Lord keep you.
Make his face to shine.
Make his face to shine.
Shine upon you.
Shine upon you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord keep you.
May the Lord keep you.
Make his face to shine.
Make his face to shine.
Shine upon you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you.
May the Lord keep you.
Make his face to shine.
Make his face to shine.
Shine upon you.
Shine upon you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord keep you.
May the Lord keep you.
Make his face to shine.
Make his face to shine.
Shine upon you. May the Lord bless you.